Hello Facebook Ads people, I'm Konstantinos and today we're going to discuss about this video that I have created and now we're going to see the progress after 1 month. If you haven't seen this video, I think you should go check it first and then come to see the second part, which is the progress, so that I will not have to say all the things that I said in the previous video on this one. And if you're lazy to do it, I don't give a you should go and you should watch the first video. So let's go on my PC. Let me show you how this account is doing after 1 month and I will see you there. So back again in this ad account, what do we see over here? We see the things that we were discussing, that the CPMs are pretty high, as you can see over here. But this is the campaign that I was talking to you about in the previous video, that now I was aiming for consistency. So I managed to get 77 sales over here. And the truth is that there is no other campaign in this account that has so many sales, even on promos and stuff. The biggest one is with 24 or whatever. So 77 says the cost per purchase is still not good, the CPMs is not so good and everything, but we have managed to also lower the cost per unique click to 2.68, which is, it's not even comparing with the others, and the CTR to 2.36. That means that in this campaign, we were actually able to get some decent results for this ad account, which is a new pixel and stuff. But now we have the other discussion, because as I told you, the initial thing is to see, can I get some results in this ad account which are going to be consistent? And if we watch on the last 7 days, we're even going better in terms of the cost per purchase that we are having over here. But if we go on the 13th, for example, 13th, zero sales. 12th, we have 3 sales. On the 11th, no sales. Then on the 10th, 1 sale. Then on the 9th, 3 sales. Then on the 8th, no sales of this one. On the 7th, 1. On the 6th, 2. On the 5th, 2. And so on and so on. What I'm trying to prove with that from the point that we were having 1 sale every 2-3 days, and that was also rare, now we're at the point that we're having sale, 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 maybe 1 day without sale, sale, sale. I want to reach to the point that we will have sales every day with my ads. Of course, right now I'm spending just $100 per day on this one, which is a new, because it's a new pixel and everything. But also, except from that, I managed to have a campaign which is working for a very long period, generating data, which is going to help me to make the pixel better and optimize better for the niche. Having lower CPM comparing to what I'm having on the other campaigns, okay? Optimizing in a hot pocket inside over here, because it's only one ad set that actually worked in a hot pocket, which gave me better cost per click, better CPM, better everything. And now that I reached the point that I have consistency, I know that over here, I'm getting this kind of results. This is where I am. How can we improve that? And this is the discussion now that you have to make with the owner and explain to him that, look, the results that you're getting right now, the CPMs, the cost per click and everything that you're getting right now is this. Can we make something better happen with the data that you, with the numbers that you can improve within the ad account? For example, can we increase the average order value? Because over here, we are getting, on the last 7 days, we're getting $86 cost per purchase, which is much better from everything else that we had so far. It is our progress. And we're getting 0.8 ROAS. In order for us to get even to 1.6, we need to get $40 cost per purchase, which is a half one. And maybe it's not even going to be enough. What does this mean? That we have a problem in the funnel. The numbers of the company are not correct. Over here, we have numbers that they don't make sense. Maybe we need to increase the average order value by doing bundles. We need to lower the cost of the products because they're super expensive and we're pushing the price of the product to be expensive. All of this kind of stuff. And this is how you know, because now you know that you have consistent sales and this is what Facebook is giving you. As I said in previous videos, nobody invited you to advertise on the Facebook platform.
Flashback.
Dear Konstantinos, please come to advertise on our platform and we will give you exactly the CPMs that you want and the return on ad spend that you want so that you can be happy and profitable. We promise. Yours sincerely, Mark Zuckerberg. And it doesn't mean that because you had an idea or a product or something, if you put it on Facebook, it's going to be profitable. The numbers also need to make sense. This is why a lot of times when I meet people that they have a brand which is already working and they don't understand how important is this, I'm telling them that they were lucky enough to have something that worked with a funnel that worked, and they never had the hassle of actually being able to find something that's working, the numbers to make sense and everything. So here we have a typical situation that we reach to the point that we can do nothing better with Facebook ads. Whatever I'm doing on top of this campaign, it's having awful CPMs, whatever you may think of, very bad cost per unique click, other creatives, it's not working. So we reach to the point that we have one campaign with one creative that is working very well. And now what we need to do is we need to improve the funnel, the numbers, the cost of the product, the shipping, the average order value, everything. Because as it stands right now, for me, with the results that we're getting over here, it's very clear that it's never going to improve to a point. Where is it going to get to? $20 cost per purchase, to 30? Still, it's not going to be enough. So something needs to change on the numbers of the company. I don't mind if someone comes and tells that he could have done it better, be my guest. But the problem here is that we need to also understand that not every business is suitable for advertising on Facebook, and unless if changes are not going to be made, I'm not going to continue working on this account because this is where I can reach it. Now, if other things come to place like influencer marketing, organic or whatever, which is going to help it, then maybe it's going to work. For sure, we know that it's selling, okay, and it can have consistent sales, but we know that the numbers of the company are not correct. And I really like and I enjoy making this kind of videos so that you can understand that it's not only a channel that is showing 6 ROAS, 7 ROAS, 5 ROAS, 2 ROAS with very high spends or whatever. It's a channel that is trying to show also content that it's deep technical so that you can understand, and it's going to help you. But because even if you have a trained pixel and a trained account, these kind of situations here help you to understand how good you are comparing to other advertisers that they haven't sorted their numbers yet. It's not fancy, but it's reality. So that's all I had to show you. As you can understand, it's not only about what you're doing in Facebook ads, the strategies that Konstantinos or somebody else is giving, but it's also about the product, the pricing, the funnels. Everything has to work flawlessly in order for you to be profitable. Don't forget that if you want to learn more, you can check my book, my free course, my paid course, my website. And until we meet again, be creative and be consistent.